All right, welcome back. Quickly, we're going to just run through what we covered in the last example in case anybody has clicked on this one. I'm going to do it very swiftly. We're going to change our background of our content to black. So let me refresh to get my original color here. Okay, so we're going to right-click, inspect element. We are going to see that div ID content is what we're looking for. We're going to go to our content. We can see the properties for our background of the content. If we click that, we can play around with it. We're going to highlight the code, and we're going to change it to all zeros. And again, we can see how that changed my background to the black. Now, as I explained, this only does this from a front-end user. Again, if I click refresh, all of my changes are going to be lost, and it's going to revert to the original file. So if we want to make the change permanent, we want to go into our admin panel. Again, I'm using Grapheme for this option, for this recording. We're going to click on Appearance and then Grapheme Options. Make sure we're on the Display tab. And we're going to open the custom CSS box. Now you can see I've already added a few elements here. So I'm going to come down to the bottom and hit the return button twice so I can start another one. Important to note, study on child themes. You want to use child themes to make these adjustments, and the reason is that when Grapheme is updated, if you hard code these adjustments into the original CSS file, you're going to lose all of those changes when the files are replaced during the update. If you use a child theme will overwrite the original elements. So the child theme will stay intact, and as updates are made, your changes will be saved here and they'll be applied to each update as they come out. So it's important to use child themes, and once I get my site set up for that, I'll do another tutorial on how to convert to start using that. But for right now, this will work. You try to keep it around a dozen or fewer lines of code here. I'm on my limit. I'm pushing it. But again, child themes are the way to go with this. So make sure you read up on that. It's in the forums that Sahir provides. So let's go back and open up our area. We're going to inspect element. We're going to make sure we're on div ID content. We are going to go to content. And what I'm going to do is just highlight all of this element here, this content background and closing tag. I'm going to copy, go back to Grapheme, and I'm just going to paste it. Well, it's not going to let me paste here. Okay, so it's going to make me type it out. Nice. I'll figure out a workaround for that. Our ID is content, and our property that we're looking for is background. So we're going to come in, and we're going to do content, and open our bracket. We are going to space to keep it pretty, and we're going to put our background in, background colon, and then I'm going to come back and double check what each property is here. We've got none, repeat, scroll, 00, and our color. So we're going to do none, repeat, scroll, 00, and then don't forget the number sign when you're using hex codes for colors. And we're going to make it 0, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And then you end it with a semicolon, hit return, and close your bracket there. So you can see how we've added this attribute into our custom CSS. So I'm going to save this option, and I'm going to come down and make sure that it's saved correctly, which it did, looks good. All right. So we're going to go back to our page. Now I'm going to close Firebug so I can get a full view, and I'm going to scroll into where I can see. And when I click the refresh button, this is live on the site, and you can see that the changes were made. So that's how you would go about changing background colors, using Firebug to determine which style element that you need to make the adjustment to. Now I'm going to go back to Grapheme, and I'm going to delete this out because obviously I don't want black on my background color. I'm going to save here. I'm going to come back over and refresh and see that my original colors were restored, and that looks good. So again, I'm going to stop this here, and I'm going to make one more tutorial real quick about more advanced things that you can do with Firebug and see how you can switch the elements around as far as positioning or inserting images into your backgrounds instead of colors. The possibilities are just limitless. So one more video coming to you about Firebug and CSS, and I hope you enjoy, and we'll talk to you shortly.